By the guidance of the Although if you are judgment of the king, the king is sound for justice. There he may judge your people in justice, and your fear in right judgment. In this place justice shall flourish, and peace will bloom forth. He shall go from sea to sea, from the great river to the earth's bounds. The kings of Persia and the sea coasts shall pay him tribute. The kings of Sheba and Sheba shall lend him peace. Before him all things shall fall prostrate, all nations shall serve him. For he shall save the poor when they cry, and the needy who are helpless. He will have pity on the weak and save the lives of men. The second reading is a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. You have probably heard how I have been impressed by God in the days he meant for you, and that it was by the revelation that I was given the knowledge of the mystery. This mystery that was now in the spirit with his holy apostles and prophets was unknown to men and in past generations. It means that parents now share the same inheritance, that they are parts of the same body, and that the same promise has been made to them in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord. The gospel of the nation. Alleluia, alleluia. We saw the star that it grows and that comes to your approach. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
After Jesus had been born at Bethlehem in Judea, during the reign of King Herod, some wise men came to Jerusalem from the east. "Where is the infant king of the Jews?" they asked. "We saw his star as it rose and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was perturbed, and so was the people of Jerusalem. He called together all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, and inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. "At Bethlehem in Judea," they told him, "for this is what the prophet told. And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, you are by no means least among the leaders of Judah, for out of you will come a leader who will shepherd my people Israel." When Herod summoned the wise men to see him privately, he asked them the exact date on which the star had appeared and sent them on to Bethlehem. "Go and find out all about the child," he said. "And when you have found him, let me know, so that I too may go and do him homage." Having listened to what the kings had to say, they set out. And there in front of them was the star they had seen rising. It went forward and hovered over the place where the child was. The sight of the star filled them with delight, and going into the house, they saw the child with his mother Mary, and falling to their knees, they did him homage. Then, opening their treasures, they offered him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. But they were warned in a dream not to go back to Herod and return to their own country by a different way. The Gospel of the Lord. It's no exaggeration to say that every story included in the Gospels is therefore the purpose of enlightening us and helping us enter more deeply into the mystery of Christ. And of course, each of the four Gospels was written for particular Christian communities, coping with the social circumstances in which they found themselves. Matthew was writing for his own Jewish people, and one of his concerns was that they grasped the fact that Jesus, while he had come to liberate them, had also come to liberate all men and women of all time. Matthew is unique in giving us the story of the wise men, mysterious travelers coming from the east, an exotic part of the world full of mystery and mystic. Having helped his own people make the necessary connection with the prophecy about Bethlehem being the place towards which they were heading, he also links their journey with Isaiah's prophetic vision of the nation seeing the light and traveling to pay homage with their needs. The wise men are there precisely to represent all of us, and even their precious gifts are of considerable significance. The goal points us to the fact that Christ's child has come to establish the kingdom of God. The incense reveals that he is no ordinary child, but God's son, while the myrrh warns us of the disturbing prospect of his passion and death. His body will need to be anointed after his death. The Church has incorporated the wonderful symbols of the wise man's gifts into the liturgy. Just think of how we use the incense to remind us not only of the preciousness of Christ's presence in the sacrament, but also of the preciousness of each and every one of us. In the funeral rite, the body, which has been anointed in the sacraments, is essential. A reminder that our mortal bodies are destined for the resurrection, because now we are Christ's adopted brothers and sisters and heirs to his kingdom. St. Paul, after his conversion, grasped the truth of all this and was at pains for the rest of his life to make sure that everyone else grasped it. Christ had come that the pagans too could share the same inheritance as his own Jewish ancestors. In today's world, the invitation to you and me to be ever conscious of the need to reach out to everyone and embrace all people as God's precious children. With so many displaced people traveling across the world to avoid persecution, warfare and violence, Pope Francis has appealed to us to see in them the face of Christ and make them welcome. This Feast of the Epiphany of the Lord provides a wonderful opportunity for us to think again about the expansive and all-embracing nature of God's revelation to the world, embodied in Jesus, and above all of what it means for us to respond to the needs of our brothers and sisters. May the Lord Jesus Christ protect our homes, families, and friends. Amen. Let us proclaim our way. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, born from the Father before all ages, God from God, light of light, true God from true. made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so, with our angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim singing.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, venis sunt celi et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus qui venit in nomine Domini.
Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be drawn for you and for man, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you return. Therefore, as we celebrate the memory of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. We give thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence in the midst of you. Humbly pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread abroad throughout the world, and bring it to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Emmanuel our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be propitious to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, and formed by the divine teaching, we are there to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, allow me thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive all who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray from every people. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Amen.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to suffer of the Lamb. Lord, I am not asking for the children of the Lord, but the Lord has the
et antiquum documentum novos ed attribui, prestet fides supplementum sensum defectui. Et nos obans
10.